the market, where should be your stop loss, and where should be your target, where should be your destination. The concept of stop loss is such that you don't incur huge losses, and there is a concept of trailing stop loss. So initially, we'll just work on the stop loss, and then we will go to the trailing stop loss so that you learn step by step, and I don't want to confuse you with so many jargons and so many things here, right? So now we'll go to the next slide. This is the welcome. You can see the bull and bear. There is an always, you know, fight between the bulls and the bears. The market goes up, then market comes down because of there is a selling by the bears. But in the end, if you see from 1979, when the Sensex was only 100 points, in 2021, each 52,000 points, and now it is trailing around somewhere around 48,000 points. The idea is that bear phase is temporary, but the bull phase is always permanent. Market crashes, and that is the time where you have to buy in the wholesale price and sell in the retail price. Like a shopkeeper, if we have a grocery store, what do? We go to the Dara Bandar, Masjid Bandar, buy in the wholesale market and sell it in the retail market to make profit. We never buy goods at a higher price, say for 100 rupees and sell at 90 rupees. That is, we are going to incur loss. So even in the share market, we have to see the company may be good, for example, Reliance, but where to enter, which level we should enter. That is very important. So now let's go to the next slide. Now this is a line chart. Now this is a candlestick chart. I'll go back again. In this line chart, we see the only closing price of the day. We cannot come to know that how much the price has gone down, where did the price open, where did the price, how much price it goes up. So there are four dimensions in the candlestick. One is the opening price, one is the closing price, and one is the high, and the fourth one is the low price. So when we see a candlestick, we come to know that on the particular day, the price went so much down, the price had opened at this level, the price has closed at this level, and the price had gone up. Now I'll come to this. Now in this candlestick, when you see a green candle, like, are you able to see my cursor? So in this candle, the price opened here, it went a little low, then it went up to high up to here, and it closed it here. So this is a very big candle, exciting candle, we can say, ERC. The movement of that particular day, the price was very high. Then when we see a red candle, then we come to know that the prices were not able to sustain to that level. It opened little high, then it came down, and then it started slowly falling down. And again, from this level, there is given one big ERC green candle, the started are moving up. So as a professional investor or a trader in the stock market, I will never buy the stock here after the rise in the price. Normally, people, what they do, they buy the stock after the rise in the price, because everywhere in the newspaper, in the CNBC, Awaz and Bazaar, they show this share has gone up by 5% or gone up by 10%. So if you calculate, it goes up by, say, 100 rupees or 200 rupees. And the layman buys when the time is here to sell the stock. So we make a mistake, we buy at the euphoria when the market is already inflated, and when we sell, that is sell in the panic in the news, when the market is down. When the market crashes or when the market is down, that is the right time to enter into the market. But we are not trained to that, so we sell when the market is down and we buy at when the market is up. So we keep on making losses or we don't make much profit like the professional traders. I'll tell you, normally in my other sessions, I tell that 5% people make the money and 95% are the loser in the stock market. But in fact, if you see, there are only 2 to 3% people who make the money, 97 to 98%, they come to the stock market and give the donation to the professional traders or professional investors. Let's see how. Understanding the candlestick. This is very, very important. Very, very important. This green candle is a bullish candle. And this red candle is a bearish candle. This means the price have come down on that particular day or for the particular hour. The candlesticks can be formed from 1 minute to 1 day to 1 week to 1 month to quarterly to half yearly to yearly. That we'll see on the later stage. Now, this is the arrow which shows that price has gone up. Where did it open? At the bottom. Where did it close? It closes above the opening price. So that means this is a bullish candle. And this was the day high of that candle. And this was the day low. So when we see a candle, we come to know by the color that the closing price is higher than the opening price. That means it's in a green color and it is a bullish candle. And by the wick, the tail, if you see the bottom and the top, you'll come to know that it went low this level and then when it went high this level. Initially, when I entered the market, say in around year 89, just before the Harshad Mehta scam, we didn't have these candlestick patterns. We didn't have any charts. We were just going by the information what the broker used to give us or what the newspaper used to tell us. But I was very keen in knowing the mechanics of the market, how the market, who means how to identify the turning point of the market, because the professional people sell and we are the buyers and we are the losers. So I was looking for this opportunity to learn these candlestick patterns. And in 2010, one American institute had come to India and the fees were very high. I don't want to quote it here. But I took the courage and I learned this candlestick pattern. And now I am making a good amount of money via in investment as well as in trading also. Let's see how. Now this red arrow comes down, which shows that the opening was high of that share and the closing was low. So this was the open price. This was the close price. This was the high it went on that day. And this, the low it made on that day. So we get, when we refer a candlestick, we come to know that the four dimension of that particular candle. Where did it open? Where did it close? How much low it went and how much high it went on that day. But in the line chart, we'll know only the closing price. So we will not know the movement, how much the share had gone up and down. Or maybe the index also, Nifty, Sensex, whatever you call. But this is how it works. Now, this is the range. The green candle closing is higher than the opening. This is the low, this is the high, and this is the total range of the candle. From the low to the high, we'll come to know the range of the candle. Why we should know the range, we'll come to know in the next slide. Let's practice. Now you come to know this high, close, low and opening. It will keep on going on each and every candle. So you'll come to know what is high, what is low and what is opening. And now once you see here, once the red candle starts forming at the top, particularly this pattern, I will teach you what is this pattern is called. then the price are going to slide down, and then there is a turning point, and then the price starts going up. So we have to identify the turning point in the stock market, in the share, particularly share, what we are interested. Until and unless we don't know the turning point and we just jump in the ocean. So we don't know, are we swimming against the current of the ocean, or are we swimming with the current of the ocean? So if, as a professional swimmer, if you swim along with the current, then you will reach your destination faster with less effort. But if you are swimming against the current of the ocean, you will get exhausted and tired, and you will never reach at your destination because the current is so huge. So you cannot fight that current against the, you cannot go against the current. So this is the high opening, close and low for this candle. This is the high opening, close and low for this candle. This is high opening, close and low for this candle. This is high opening, low and close for this candle. Now this is an ERC, we call this expanded range candle, because it has a very tremendous move. So it is like a candle, you know, before the candle, you know, there is no wax left now. It is the last. So it glitters more before blowing off. So this is the extinguishing candle, which will give you a signal when there is an exponential rise, then you should be cautious. You should not enter after this candle, until and unless there are some other parameters which I'm going to teach you on the next slide. So this is high, open, close and low. There is no wick. So whatever the price it opened, that was the high of that candle, and then it went low, and then it closes little above, but still it's a red candle because it's a bearish. The opening was higher than the closing price. This is high, close, open and low. Now, we go to the next slide. Now, this is the range of the candle. If the candle is here in this range between 80% to 100%, that means that candle is very bullish. Between 80 to 60%, it is bullish. Between 60 to 40, it is neutral. Neutral means if you are driving a car or a bike, now the bike you get without means automatic, so you don't have to press the clutch. But when you are driving manually, when you want to change the gear, either you want to go up or go down, you will put the gear into the neutral. So when it comes into the 60 to 40% range, that means it shows that the market, the movement is going to change, but I don't know where, right? It may go fast or it may go down, up. So now suppose if your destination is from Mumbai to USA, New York, say, the flight takes off, then it lands in UK or in Paris, you fuel it, and then it goes further. So when this is a neutral, 60 to 40%, so you have to take care that there is a turning point in the market, whether it will go up from here or whether it will go back. 40 to 20%, it is a bearish, and from 20 to 0%, it is very bearish. Now, these are the candles which will show you that they are very bearish. See this red candle on the left where my cursor is moving, very bearish. This is also very bearish. The price went up to here and then it started coming down, and it closed below the opening price. So this is a very bearish candle. Although this color of the candle is green, but many of you will misunderstand that this is a bullish candle. No, the prices went up, then it came down. although the prices closed above the opening prices, but still from the high, if you calculate, it comes into the 0 to 20% of the range of that candle. So it is a bearish candle, although the color is green. This is also a bearish candle. This is, again, I'll call it an ERC without any wick or tail. This is a very bearish candle. These are also bearish candle. Although you will see the center candle is in green color, but if you see the wick here, from the prices went up here, and it came down. So it comes in the range of 40 to 20%. So this is also a bearish candle, although the color is green. These are the neutral candle. Why they are neutral candle? That the wick, if you compare the wick and the body is less than the 50% of the range. Are you getting my point? This body of this candle, if we compare from the high and low of this wick, it is not making 50%. It is less than 50%. So these are the neutral candles. When you find these neutral candles, you have to take a pause. This will give you that the share price or the market is going to change the gear, whether it is going on the higher gear or whether it will go to the lower gear. Suppose if it is on the third gear, so maybe it will go to the top gear on the fourth, or it will come down to the second gear and slowly to the first gear and then halt. So we have to be very careful when we see this candle, then how to use this candle for our advantage. These are the bullish candles. Even there is a red color candles here, you see. But if you see from the low, it went up to here, pushing the prices here. Although the closing was less than the opening price, but there was a tremendous buying here that the market, that share market or the share price went up to here. Even this is a bullish candle, the opening is higher and the body is higher than the wick, more than 50%. Even this red color candle shows that there was a tremendous buying pressure here. There were no sellers here. All the seller, whatever the amount or the quantity of that particular stock was there, it was absorbed and there were no more sellers and the prices went up again here. So this is a very bullish candle. Now these are very bullish. Even if you see this red candle, but what does the price action says? The price action says that here the buying pressure was so much that it absorbed all the sellers and the market, and it went up and it made a very bullish candle. Identifying patterns for demand and supply. Now, this is what you have to learn. This is very important slide, which I'm going to send it to you, because basis on this, we are going to make our decision whether I should buy the stock or whether I should sell the stock. Now, I have just made a three candles to make you understand. The candle should be an ERC expanded range candle. So there is, on the left, there is a legging, then there is a base foundation, that neutral candle, and there is a leg out. Even in the supply also, there is on the left-hand side, there is a green candle, then there is a base, and then there is a red candle, which is a base candle, means it is a leg out candle. So you need three things. The candle should be an ERC expanded range candle, that is the body should be greater than 50%. and the candle should be a narrow range candle. In between the basing candle should be less than 50%. Now the candle should be an exciting expanded range candle. That is, the body should be greater than the 50% of the range of the candle, and the size of the candle should be bigger than the average candles. The size of the candle should be bigger than the average candle. Then we come to know that it is a leg out. Now, I'll just make you understand that while when we are doing the PT or where we were in the school, we used to do that, you know, march pass. What was the first word? Left, right, left. It was never right, left, right. It was always said left, right, left. Left, right, left. So left candle is the candle which will enter the demand zone or which will enter the supply zone. Many people say the demand zone is a support zone, and many people say supply zone is a resistance level. So when the left candle enters either of the zone, then there are one or two small candles, the basing candles, the less than the 50% are formed, and then there is a leg out on the right. Now we have to mark that level, that here the buyers exceed the sellers. That means there is a lot of demand at this particular price or at this particular range. So whenever the prices comes next time into that level, we are the buyers. And whenever the prices reach that supply zone or the resistance zone, we are the sellers. Now, parts of candlesticks. See, this is called the upper wick, the tail. Either you call it a tail or an upper wick. This is called a body, and this is called a lower wick. Buying cheap, selling expensive, or buying at wholesale price and selling at retail price, or buying in support or demand, whatever you call that. So we have a buying band, then selling in resistant supply, where the supply is so much that there are no buyers and the prices comes down. So we call it a selling band. And selling expensive, buying cheap. It can be reverse. You know, I do both the ways. When the market is up, and if I don't have shares also, I sell it on the future contract and then I buy it when the prices comes down. So you will need that expertise and that eye to know that when to buy and when to sell. Selling retail, buying at wholesale price. Now, like I will tell you, for example, now this is a season of mango, right? And I have a contact in Ratnagiri. So I will sell the mango for here, say 750 rupees. But in Ratnagiri, I will have a tie-up that they will supply me at 500 rupees. So I am making a profit of 250 rupees. Although I don't have the stock, but I have committed to that buyer that I'll sell you that mangoes for 750 rupees. So after getting the money, I make a buy order there and then supply to the retailer. So this is the way you have to think in the stock market also. Selling in resistance, supply or selling band, we'll come to, I'll explain you that in further in the next slide. Buying in support or demand or the buying band, whatever the terminology is used, because I don't want to confuse. So I'm just making it very simple here. Now, this is the chart. Now, where is the support band here? Because the prices came up from here and then it started coming down here and then it went up. Then again, it started going up. Then again, it started. This is a sideways market where there is a resistance where the people sell. And this is the support band where the people buy. Conservative way, there are three ways to buy. One is conservative way, one is preferred way, and one is aggressive way. Stop loss will be always below or high of the turning point with the wiggle room. And target will be always 1:3 for swing, positional and investment trade up setup. For day trade, one may go for 1:2 trade setup, but then you will have to be very expert in this when you are taking a day trade. I normally don't encourage people for a day trade, but since the pandemic is there and people have a lot of time and they want to have generate more income, so we can go for this type of setup 1:2 while sitting at home. Also, we can make money if we get this expertise. Now, what is the conservative way to buy? Now, this is the prices have come down. And here, you know, this red candle is the legging. What I was showing you in the earlier slide, this is the legging, the left, on the left candle, right? Now, this is the base candle. The green one, the small one, is the base candle. And now the prices have started moving up. So next time when I want to buy, the conservative way will be, I will buy at the opening price, the low of the body. Because I'm very conservative. Why I'm conservative? Because I want to make my losses very small and my profits very huge. So my stop loss will be below this wiggle room. So I'm giving a wiggle room that sometimes what happens, the price comes down little further down and then it starts going up. So I don't want to get stopped out early. So I will give that wiggle room. And then when the price again comes down to that level, I will enter here. I will buy here because I have seen that from here, the market went up or that particular share went up or that particular equity went up. And now it is giving me that there were more number of buy orders than the sell orders. That's why the market went up and there are unfilled orders. So when the market will come here, I am going to buy here. And if the trade is not in my favor and if it goes further down, I will be get stopped out here. So now if you see the range, my loss will be 1 rupee loss per share. But if I'm making a profit, I'll be making a 3 rupees profit per share. This is just to make you understand. Preferred way to buy. Now that was a conservative way. Now I'm giving you the preferred way to buy. The market is coming down. There is a legging on the left. This is a left candle on the legging, very big candle. After a big candle, there has to be a change. Normally, when there is an ERC, that means the candle is going to be exhausted. Now, this is a basing here. And the market has gone up. Now, where the preferred way is where I will buy. I will buy the top of the body, not the low of the body of the basing candle. And where will be my stop loss? My stop loss will be the same. Are you getting my point? But here, my risk is more. In conservative method, my risk was very less. And I can have always 1:3 target, but this will give me, if my trade is not going in my favor, so I'm going to lose more money. So now when the price comes again, I will enter at this level and keep my stop loss here where you have seen the arrow stop. And my target will be here from where the market has come down, the opposite side. And there is an aggressive way to buy also. Like when you become very expert, you don't want to leave any chance. So what you do is, this is the legging. Then there is a base candle. And then the market has gone up. Now you identify that this is the wick. The high of that base candle is your entry point. And this is the stop loss. So when the price comes again here in this level, what you do is you enter the market. But in this case, what happens? Your risk is greater than the conservative and greater than the preferred way. But after some times, when you become expert, you won't mind taking a risk because you have the expertise, you have the experience, and you have made money. So your confidence level will go up. But if you ask me, Today also, I am not an aggressive trader or an aggressive investor. I wait for the price to come to my level. If they come to my level, I buy. Otherwise, I don't chase the price. I let it go. I will wait. I will have patience. There are n number of scripts which will be available for trading. So don't chase the price and buy it. The moment you buy it, the price after that, it will start coming down. So you have to know that where, from which airport my plane should take off. That is very important. Now, conservative way to sell also. Now, these prices are going up, up. Now, this is a base candle. Now, after you get a small body candle, the what we call is a boring candle or a basing candle or a neutral candle, whatever. There are n number of names which are given. So I am just giving you all the names because tomorrow if you do any search, and then you will get confused. But this is a pattern. Now, after this three candles rise, if you find this type of a candle, that means the trend is going to change. And it is coming down, right? Now, as a conservative seller, I will sell at the top of the body, that is the opening of that candle, right? And my stop loss will be above. I'm giving a wiggle room. But if you see here, what is my stop loss? Very less, right? Now, when the price again comes into that level, I am going to sell that script because it has already given me that after reaching here, 1, 2, 3 candles, it has continuously gone down. So I am going to sell here. Although if I don't have shares, I can sell it in the future contract, or I can buy a put, or I can sell a call. There are many ways you can do this. This is called a future FNO that I'm just giving. I'm not discussing that topic right now because it will take some time for you to reach that level, but I'm just showing you that this is where your stop loss should be. So if by chance, if there is one more candle which is hitting and going up, so you know that this is my stop loss. The trade is in not my favor. I'll make a small loss and I will exit the trade. Preferred way to sell. What is the preferred way? It is going up. Again, it has made a small neutral candle. That means it is given me a signal that price are going to change. The trend is going to have a reversal. The share price or the market is coming down. Now, when the preferred way is the low of the body when I'm selling it. And my stop loss is above. The stop loss is going to be the same, but my risk here is increased from the conservative way into the preferred way. Now, when the market comes up again, I am going to sell this. I am going to sell this and keep my stop loss. And the market starts going down. I will book my target and make profit. If the trade is in not my favor, my stop loss is in place, I will exit from the trade. I'll make a small loss, but higher than the conservative way. Now, there is one more way, aggressive way to sell. The market is going up. It makes a small neutral body. Now, the market comes down. I have marked the entry. Where I have marked the entry? The low of that candle. And where is my stop loss? Stop loss is the same, but the margin, if you see, my risk component has increased. Are you getting my point? So if the trade is not in my favor, I am going to make a huge loss. Are you getting my point? So I would prefer the preferred way, not the conservative way, not the aggressive way, the preferred way, where my loss is minimum. And in conservative, it is very, very minimum. But I will go into the preferred way. Now, this is the Dr. Reddy's chart. Long back ago, I had made it for the presentation. So this was the resistance level. So I'm telling you to short it. Normally, people in the stock market, whenever you go, if the market is overinflated also, they will not advise you to sell. They will always say, kharido. Because our mentality right from the childhood is to buy, buy and buy. Right? So we don't become a seller. We always become a buyer, even at the inflated price. So this is the resistance level. So if my entry is at 3648, my stop loss is 3727. So if the mark, the trade is in not my favor, I'm going to make this much loss. What is my risk component? Can you see it? And if I go to the support level, if I buy at the support level, can you see what is my reward? More than three times the risk what I'm taking. So in any, whether it is commodity, whether it is currency, or whether it is you buy gold or silver in the stock market or any script, or whether you trade in Nifty or Bank Nifty or Sensex, this should be your strategy. Minimum loss. Suppose I'm taking a risk of 1 rupees, I should at least get the reward of 3 rupees. If the reward of 3 rupees is not seen, I should not enter into that trade. So this reward ratio is 3-1, risk rupees 79 and reward is rupees 332 rupees. If you multiply, it is more than 3. It is almost 4 times. So 1:4, if you calculate the risk reward ratio. So this should be your strategy. This is one more chart to make you understand that this is the entry point here at 3317 and you see that dotted line 3238, that is the stop loss and this is the target at 3608.40. So 291 rupees profit I am making it and the loss, if the trade is not in my favor, is 79 rupees. Even if you calculate it, this is more than 1:3 ratio. So always your strategy, your charting has to be done in such a way that your risk is minimized and your profit is accelerated. Step 5, risk reward and position sizing. Capital considered for investment, say rupees 5 lakhs. Now you allocate 5 lakh rupees. The risk considered is 1%. So risk per trade will be 5,000 rupees. An application is 1:3 ratio to profit. That is 15,000 per trade. If I'm incurring a loss, I'm incurring a loss of 5,000 rupees. Scenario 1, 50% winning trades, 50% losing trades. 10 trades are executed with 1:3 ratio. 5 trades are in loss, 5,000 per trade. 5 traders are in profit, 15,000 per trade. Total loss incurred is 25,000 rupees. Total profit incurred is 75,000 rupees. Conclusion, profit exceeds loss by 50,000 rupees. 40% winning trades and 60% losing trades. 10 trades are executed with 1:3 ratio. 6 trades are in loss, rupees 5,000 per trade. 4 trades are in profit, rupees 15,000 per trade. Total loss incurred, 30,000 rupees. Total profit incurred, 60,000 rupees. Conclusion, profit exceeds loss by 30,000 rupees. The worst scenario, scenario number 3. 30% winning trades, 70% losing trades. 10 trades are executed with 1:3 ratio. 7 trades are in loss, 5,000 per trade. 3 trades are in profit, rupees 15,000 per trade. Total loss incurred is 35,000 rupees. Total profit incurred is 45,000 rupees. Conclusion, profit exceeds loss by 10,000 rupees. So with this strategy, you have to be very disciplined. You cannot just say, you cannot have a laid back attitude. Nahi, ye price abhi maine liya hai toh ye badega. No. If the trade is not in your favor with the strict discipline, the loss has to be booked. You have to cut your losses. Then also means with this type, if you have a discipline and this methodology, that even after 70% of the trades are not in your favor, then also you make money, you don't lose the money. basing candle and narrow range candle. A candle whose body is less than 50% of the total range of the candle is called a basing candle. Narrow range candle is 50% or less than 50% of the ATR. Now, what is this ATR? That is the average true range of that particular script or that particular share or the Nifty or the Sensex. What they do is they calculate the last 14 days average. What was the movement of that day? What was the opening? And what was the high? What was the low? And what was the close? And they divide it by 14 days. They add it and then they come to know that this is the true range of that particular script or the particular index, whether it is Bank Nifty or Nifty. So this is the basing candle. Narrow range candle, it may not have a wick also, then also this is called a narrow range candle or a basing candle, or they call it a boring candle. How to draw support band or a resistant band? You need two legs to draw a support or a resistant band, a left leg and a right leg. So always when I call you left, right, so left leg is always the leg in, whether it is the market is coming down and it is taking a pause, then there will be a basing candle, and the right is always coming out, whether it is in the demand zone or whether it is in the supply zone. You call demand zone as a support zone and the supply zone as a resistance zone. So don't get confused. So I'm using both the terminology because there are many people, you confuse that this is the support and resistance and this is the demand and supply. What we are supposed to do is here is to identify the turning point of the market or the turning point of the script. Am I making some sense? Well, whatever the terminology is, we are going to identify the turning point from the top or from the bottom when it starts going up, or from the when the market reaches high and it starts coming down. So we are going to identify that turning point. The space between the two legs will be called as a base, which will consist of one or more boring or narrow range candle, preferably two basing candle or two narrow range candle for high probability trades. If there are too many candles, right, then you have to avoid that trade. If there are one or two or three maximum, then that trade setup is a very good trade setup. Left leg will arrive, lands in the band, then the after basing right leg outs and takes off the departure from the band. Exciting and expanded range candle. A candle where the real body is more than the 50% of the range of the candle is called exciting. ERC, expanded range candle, where the candle range is almost equal to the average true range. Now suppose if the Reliance share is moving 100, the ATR is 100, and that candle is almost that they gave a movement of 100 rupees or more than 100 rupees, then that candle is called ERC, expanded range candle, or the exciting candle, and it is visually appears to be very strong candle. So you will come to know that there was a lot of buying or a lot of selling, and then the prices came down. So from the ERC, you will come to know where actually the price, what is the price action of that particular script. Now try to understand this slide. It is very important. This is the resistance band or the selling band or the supply zone where it halts for a, there was a rally, there was rise in price, and then for one or two days, the price were, not moving very fast. It was like a boring trade, the opening and closing were very close. And after that, the prices goes down. So now this is my left arm. What I said, left, right, left. So this is the left arm or the left leg. The prices are going up. And then there is a halt here. The plane is landed in between. It is going to take a halt here. It will refuel. Now, I don't know from Mumbai to Delhi, it will go to London or that plane will again come back to Mumbai. So this is, it flew from Mumbai to Delhi. It refueled here and then it came back again to Mumbai. So what is this? The left arm is the landing, is the leg in, and the right arm, the departure from the airport, is coming back. So this is the right. So always there will be left, right, and in between there will be a basing candle. This is how you are supposed to draw your band, resistant band as well as the support band. Resistant band means it is a selling band where when the prices comes again in that band, you have to sell it. And what is the support band? It is a demand. It's a buying band. Whenever the prices comes in that level, you have to buy. How to draw the support band? See, again, it is left. From the left side, the prices came into that band. And then you see these two candles are formed here. And then the prices, that is the departure, that is the right arm, left, basing, and right. Even when prices go up, it is left, basing, and right, it is the departure. So whether it is buying or selling, you have to follow this pattern, then entry, stop loss, and target. How to plot the bands? There are three components to plot the band. The left arm, that is arrival, basing one or more candles, but not more than 3 to 4. Right arm is the departure. Like military march, we start with left, right, left. Here also we have to start with left, right, left. For support band from current price. Now I'm going to the live market after some time. I'll show you the live chart. The current price, we look down to the left or green color strong expanded range candle, ERC. The right arm, that is the departure, immediately after one or more basing candle, NRC, that is narrow range candle also. This we identify as a platform or a base or an airport for the plane to land and again to take off. The preceding basing candles, the arrival landing of the left arm into the band. Permanent and flexible lines. Now, what are these permanent and flexible lines? The permanent line or the file line is called the distal lines. That is the file line of the band. That is, either it is on the high, if it is resistance, and it is very low if it is in the support level. The bands are turning point to the price action and on which chart are placed at the price extremes which cannot be moved as stop loss are placed below or above these lines. So this line cannot be moved. These distal lines cannot be moved. I'll take you that example into the chart. The flexible line or a fine tuning line, that proximal lines of the bands are the lines closer to the current price and can be shifted to fine tune to reduce the risk portion on the lower time frame or entry or buy or sell order. Trends, there are three trends. The trends are, one is the uptrends, prices make a new high. Downtrend, prices make a new low. Sideways, the trend, prices move in the same range, same highs and same lows are made over a period of time. So it, the price moves in a particular range. Say suppose the price of a particular XYZ share is at 800 rupees, it goes up to 1000 rupees. Then again, it comes down to 800 rupees. Then again, it goes to 1000 rupees. So that is called a sideways trend. When the breakout happens above 1000 rupees or below 800 rupees, if the breakout happens above 1000 rupees, the price is going to make a new high. So there is also one way, that is called a breakout trade. So after getting some expertise, we will work on the breakout trade. Yesterday, I did one breakout trade in the gold commodity. I saw that price was moving in a particular range and then it gave me a breakout. I entered and I made 2,500 rupees within 15 minutes and I closed the trade. So this will come with expertise. The more you do it and then you will come to know, then I will teach you how to enter into the breakout trade. Till then, we should only focus on the support, that is the demand or the buying band or the selling zone or the supply or the resistance zone where the prices turns and comes down. The sideways trend prices move in the same range, same highs and same lows are made over a period of time. Now, this is how you will know the stock market is trending, or it is in sideways, or it is in a downtrend. Now, look at my cursor here. This is called an impulsive move, right? And the prices comes down. This is called an corrective move. This red line which has come down is called a corrective move. After taking the support from this trend, the prices again goes up. It is making a higher high than the previous high. Can you see this? This high is greater than the previous high. And this low is also higher than the previous low. So you can call this as an uptrend. Now market comes to this trending line, then again it goes up. So there is, in an uptrend, there is an impulsive move towards up and then corrective move towards down. Then again, there is an impulsive move which goes up. Then again, there is a corrective move. Now in sideways market, what happens? The impulsive move and the corrective move is almost the same. Now this gives me an indication that the market is going to remain sideways, or that particular script is going to remain sideways for a particular period. And suppose if it wants to make a new high, it will break this band, it will go up. But if it is making or breaching this support band, then it will come down. Then this downtrend will become an impulsive move, and the corrective move is a small. Then again, there is a down. That impulsive move is bigger than the corrective move. Then there is a corrective move. Then again, it comes down. So we have to identify now where we have to enter. Now, suppose I am want to buy this script. So I'm going to buy it here at this level or at this level. I will never buy at this level because it has exhausted. Now the market is moving sideways. And normally what they do, people enter here. People enter at this level. People enter at this level and the market starts coming down. And you say, ke main share leta hun aur market girti hai. This was happening with me in 1989, 1991, 92. I made some money. Then after the scam, I lost it. But I wanted to know the mechanism of the market, that how to identify. So I learned this candlestick pattern and the trend pattern. And now I am successful, and I want, because of the pandemic, many businesses are not going well and people are sitting at home. So this is, I want to bring it out, that with sitting at home also with expertise, you can make money. It depends upon how much capital and how much risk appetite you have. You can make a lot of money in this market, whether it is in commodities, whether it is in currency, crude oil, or equity market. Now, here you try to understand the impulse move is in the dominant or in the same direction of the trend. And whereas the corrective move is in the opposite direction, an opposite direction of the trend. See, even while going up, this was an impulsive move, and the corrective move is in the opposite direction. Then this is an impulsive move, and then there is a corrective move in the opposite direction, and it is goes in the same direction. And this is what the sideways is. Now, this is very, very important to know the trend. If you don't know the trend, and if you know that if you are entering at a high level, then there is a high risk. The price may not go up because it has to come down to have more fuel. And after taking a fuel, whether it will from Delhi, it will go to UK or it will come back to Mumbai again. So you have to take the broader market view and then enter in the market. Otherwise, people burn their money, blow up their capital like anything. Now, this is a trend line. This is an uptrend. This is the real candlestick, which I have taken it from the chart. Now see my cursor here. This was an impulsive move. Then this was a corrective move. Then there was an impulsive move. This was a corrective move. Then there was an impulsive move. And then there was a basing here. And it broke the trend line. Now the market or the share price started falling down. To know the trend, it is very important. Once it breaks this dotted trend line, that means the uptrend has come to an end. The market is going to hold for some time and then it is going to crash. This is very important to know. If it is breaching the trend line, whether uptrend or downtrend, then you have to be very cautious. Now, this is the downtrend. Can you see this? Two peaks and the prices are coming down. Just to identify that how to draw the trend line. This is a downtrend. Initially, this was an uptrend. Then the prices started coming down. So, if there is a downtrend, I am not supposed to buy the stock till it reaches the bottom. How to identify the bottom? The buying support at buying at support level or the demand level. And if you want to sell, you will sell it at the resistance level or the supply zone. This is continuation pattern, you know, steep highs. It goes, there is a one or two basing candle, it goes up. Then there is a one or two basing candle, it goes. There is one basing candle, it goes. Now, when it breaks this trend line, the prices comes down. So this is what you have to understand. Now, see, this was the band which was drawn that if the prices comes here in this level, I will buy it. Then it gave a bounce, but it did not give a bounce of 1:3 or maybe 1:2. Then it stayed for quite a long time and then prices started breaking. Once it breaks the support zone or the demand zone, the prices are definitely going to come down again to buy at this level. So this is the cycle which keeps on repeating. So you have to be very smart to identify that where I should enter the market. See, this is the support zone. This is where you have to enter the market and it will give you a bounce of 1:3. Uptrend, two valleys or three CP patterns, continuation pattern, aggressive trend line, very steep. I've shown you that higher highs are made and higher lows are made in an uptrend. Supports are respected and resistance are taken out. Downtrend, two peaks or three CP patterns, continuation pattern, aggressive trend line is very steep. Lower highs made and lower lows are made. Resistance are respected and supports are taken out. Sideways trends. One of the support or resistance has been taken out and then the trend is in sideways. When two supports on daily time frame are taken out, then on daily it is a downtrend. And in this case, we look for a support on a weekly time frame to buy to go long. When two supports on a weekly has been taken out, then we look for monthly support to buy or go long. Resistance level. When two resistance on daily has been taken out, then we look for a weekly resistance to sell or go short. When two resistance on a weekly has been taken out, then we go on a monthly resistance to sell or go short. Now there will be a different time frame, we'll have a different trend. Now suppose on a long term, on the monthly chart, if that candle is of a 1 month, then candle can be of one candle can be of for a 1 month also, one candle will be for a 1 week also, for 1 day also, 60 minute also, 5 minute also, and 1 minute also. But I'm talking about the long term, that is the monthly trend, will be uptrend. Then intermediate trend, that means on the weekly chart, it will be uptrend or a downtrend. So on the short term, what I have to do, if it is in a downtrend, on a monthly, it is on a high uptrend, but on a weekly, it is showing me a downtrend. So on the short term chart, that is on day chart, I will look for the buy. Because if I buy at that corrective move on the support of the trend line, the prices are going to go up. But if it is on the monthly also, it is on an uptrend, weekly also on an uptrend, and daily also uptrend. So I'm not supposed to buy till it comes to my particular level. Otherwise, I will burn my money. The curve analysis. And thank you all. Now this you can take a screenshot or I will send it to you. This is my Telegram channel. This is my Green Wallet email ID, this is my Facebook Green Wallet page, and this is for the YouTube, because every time I'm going to put up some new videos so that you can, you know, look to that videos and take a proper decision. Now I will go to the live market chart where I can show you how the market is going to work. Now this is a live chart. This is of the Nifty. You might be hearing about the Nifty. Aaj Nifty kitna upar gaya. So this is the current level of the Nifty. Nifty is trading here at this level, right? And this is the chart which I am using is of the Zerodha. Now these two, if I'll draw one more line here. Now this was this line, what you see here, where my cursor is, the market came down and it is going sideways. You know, for quite some time, I'll draw one more line. I'll change the color so you'll come to know. The market is moving in this range. You know, the Nifty has become sideways. Now, as a layman, you will enter in this market. But if you ask me where I should enter the market, so I will wait for the price. I will draw one more line here to make you understand. The price has gone up here, then it has come down here, then it has come down here, then it has come down here, then it has gone up here now. It has made a new, means it is higher than the previous high. Then again the market has come down here, and now from here it is in between now. Now if you ask me, as a professional, I will wait in this sideways market. I will wait for the signal. It will be a breakout trade either on the upside or on the downside. I'll show you how. From here, the market can go here. Then it can touch here this resistance line, and then it can make a new high. That is one scenario, right? So I will wait. If I want to buy, I will wait for this band to break out. This is called a breakout trend. Now I'm not talking about the support and resistance. This is something, a new strategy, which will take some time, but I'm explaining you the current scenario. What I am going to do is I'll wait for this market to give me a breakout, and then it will test here, and then I will enter here, and then there is a chances that it will breach the previous high and it will make a new high. The second scenario is, from here, the market may go little up, then come down, then go little up, and then it will break this. The support zone or the demand zone. So when it is breaking here, I will sell the market. Either it is Nifty or whatever shares I have, whatever the scrip is going down, when it breaks this level, breaches, that means the market or the scrip is not respecting this support zone. And there are chances now the market will go further down. So I am not a buyer here. If I cannot sell it, but I will definitely not buy it. I will make the market to come down to this level where after a steep fall, it has gone up. Can you see here? I'll just draw one more line to make you understand. See here, after a steep fall, the market rose up to here, you know, very big move. So I will draw my support band here. Are you getting me? What I was showing in the slide, this is my support band or my demand zone, where I have seen that when it fall down, there was a tremendous demand and the prices shoot up to here. And it breached this previous resistance, the supply zone from where it has come down. So now this shows that there are more number of buyers here. The buy orders are still there. That's why the prices shoot up. So when the market will come down at this level, say what it is, 13,400 to 13,300 level, I'll be the buyer of this Nifty or if any scrip is there. So this will be my scenario where if I want to buy Nifty, I'll buy it here or I'll buy it here on the breakout. So this is very important. Now, I am ready to take the question answers. You can put me on the chat. Chat. Very low voice, if you can raise. Okay. Sir, what was the second last slide? Second last slide of what? Achai, any questions you can put here or you can, you know, unmute your mic and tell. If there are any questions, you can unmute your mic and also ask me. So there are no questions. Okay, second last slide on my PPT. Yeah, the moving average, you cannot learn everything on the one day. So there are many things which I'm going to take up in the next week. That is moving average, I'm going to take it. Then I'm going to teach you what is RSI, then what is ADX, and what is stochastics. There are many indicators, Bollinger Bands. In one day, in 1.5 hour, it is not possible. So every topic will have something. I will teach you what is the breakout, what is 21-day moving average, what is the significance of 55-day moving average. So that is going to take time. You cannot learn everything on one day. Let's go to yours. The curve analysis. The curve analysis, price must be at the extreme top or bottom, above or below 70% of the curve from me to take any entry. So that is, again, you know, it will take some time for you to learn to get familiar with the candlesticks, and then it can be taught in the next session. Yeah, it could be. See, what I am going, it can be 13,800 to 13,300 rupee, 300, the Nifty. But this is my tentative support zone, where I am minimizing my risk factor. Drawing of this band is support or resistance is to minimize your risk factor. And this is not in one day that you will able to learn. So you will have to give some time, and then I'm going to give you some homework. If people who will draw these candles, either green or red, and post it on the WhatsApp, we'll get the Zoom link for the next session or next webinar on preferably on Sunday. And then I'm going to take you on the live this thing, live market in the morning from 8:45 to 10, where how to trade in the live market when the candlesticks are forming, right? Whether it is forming a demand zone or whether it is forming a supply zone or support or resistance, and how to trade. That is very important if you want to become a scalper or a day trader. So kindly note down, the one candle is the opening price is 100 rupees. I just want you to be smart enough. Take down on your pen or on your WhatsApp. Opening price is 100 rupees. Closing price is 105. High is 108 and low is 98. So you have to draw this candle, or I'll put it on the WhatsApp, and you have to send me whether it is a red color candle, bearish candle, or it is a bullish candle. The second candle is, the price is, opening price is 200, closing price is 190, the high is 210 and low is 180. The third candle is, the opening price is 150, the closing price is 140, and high is 150 and low is 135. The person who will draw these candles and send it to me, I'll put this in the WhatsApp chat so that nobody tells that it was, I didn't get a chance to note down. We'll only get the Zoom link for the next webinar. This is a very personalized training I'm giving it to you, which will, if you go to any other institute, it's going to cost you a bomb. And because I am doing on a day-to-day basis, and I'm benefiting it, so I want more people to get benefit in this pandemic and start, you know, making money while sitting at home. So, goodbye. This slide also, I'm going to put it on the WhatsApp, the last slide, where you can join my Telegram channel, you can see my YouTube channels, and then we can take it forward. So I will end this meeting here. Have a good day.
Have a good day. Good night.
Good night.